Hello and welcome to this week's Gospel Reflection. Let's begin with prayer. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Come, Holy Spirit, come by means of the powerful intercession of the Immaculate Heart of Mary, thy well-beloved spouse. Saint Cecilia, pray for us. The rulers sneered at Jesus and said, "He saved others, let him save himself. If he is the chosen one, the Christ of God." Even the soldiers jeered at him. As they approached to offer him wine, they called out, "If you are King of the Jews, save yourself." Above him there was an inscription that read, "This is the King of the Jews." Now one of the criminals hanging there reviled Jesus, saying, "Are you not the Christ? Save yourself and us." The other, however, rebuking him, said in reply, "Have you no fear of God? For you are subject to the same condemnation, and indeed we have been condemned justly. For the sentence we received corresponds to our crimes, but this man has done nothing criminal." Then he said, "Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom." He replied to him, "Amen, I say to you, today you will be with me in paradise." If you couldn't tell from the readings, this Sunday is the Feast of Christ the King. And what I'm going to say, I'm sure you already know, but let me remind you. Our King is not like any other King. Yes, He is absolutely the King of heaven, and He is the King of earth, and He desires that His kingships spread to every home and to every heart. The crown that He wears is not a crown of gold and jewels, but a crown of thorns. He doesn't only wear a crown of thorns on his head, he wears a crown of thorns around his heart. Traditionally, on the Feast of Christ the King, it has been a custom to pray a consecration prayer to the Sacred Heart of Jesus. Why is there this link between the heart of Jesus and the kingship of Christ? It's precisely because the crown he wears is around the heart. But why the heart? In Judeo-Christian anthropology, the heart is a sign of the giving of the entire person. When a man gives his heart to a woman, or he says, "I give you my heart," that means, "I give you all that I am, all that I have. I pour myself out completely out of love for you." Jesus Christ himself is a complete gift of self. He is love itself. On the cross, he gives himself completely, fully, body, blood, soul, and divinity. He pours out every single drop of blood. There's an important thing that we have to keep in mind, that we have to spread devotion and we have to spread the rule of Christ the King here on earth. And I'm going to give you a couple of tips on how to do that. And I'm going to give you these tips based on inspirations from the apparitions of Jesus to Saint Margaret Mary Alacoque. Now, Jesus appeared to Saint Margaret Mary and revealed to her the importance of the devotion of the Sacred Heart. And he gave many promises to those who would keep this devotion to the Sacred Heart. So yes, it's true that Jesus said that if you have a devotion to the Sacred Heart, he will give you the graces necessary to live out your state in life. He will help a lukewarm soul to become very fervent. He will help priests to convert hardened sinners. He will be there at the hour of your death to give you consolation and grace. Those are all true, but the one I really want to focus on at this moment is images of the Sacred Heart. Jesus promised to Saint Margaret Mary that anywhere that his image is honored and exposed and reverenced, that there will be peace in that place. There are two standards, so to speak, two banners, two teams that you can play for. We have the standard or the banner of Jesus Christ, or we have the standard or the banner of Satan. We have to make a choice. We can either be for Jesus or be for Satan. If you would imagine your home and all the world as a battlefield, how many homes, how many families are under the reign and the kingship of Satan? And how many families are under the reign and the kingship of Christ? By putting the image of Christ in your home, it's like putting up a flag saying, "This house belongs to Jesus Christ." So I strongly encourage you, O Christian person, I strongly encourage you to put an image of the Sacred Heart of Jesus in your home and in a prominent place in your home. And Jesus himself promises that he will bring peace to the family. He'll bring peace to all of those who have a devotion to his Sacred Heart in the home. And not only that, why is it important to have this image? Because again, holding out the heart, The heart is a reminder of what we are called to. We are called to be united to the heart of Christ, to be meek, to be humble, and that heart has a crown of thorns. That means a life of sacrifice. The Christian life, the victory of Christ, the kingship of Christ is won by a life of sacrifice. So put an image of the Sacred Heart of Jesus in your home and make room right next to it for an image of the Immaculate Heart of Mary. We'll talk about the Immaculate Heart of Mary in a couple of weeks, but for now, the Sacred Heart of Jesus. Second tip that I have for you. According to St. Margaret Mary and approved by the Church, Jesus promised that anybody who receives Holy Communion on the first Friday of the month for 9 consecutive months, that Jesus himself would be there at the hour of your death, providing for you the graces necessary for your salvation, providing for you the grace of final perseverance. He promised that nobody who keeps this devotion will die without the sacraments of the Church. You will have the sacraments available to you at the hour of your death. This is very important. This is basically promising you salvation. Keep the 9 first Fridays. And to truly be a child of Jesus Christ is to reach out to save other souls. So once the 9 first Fridays are over, enter into the reparation, enter into the sacrificial love of Jesus Christ, and continue to offer the first Fridays for the salvation of somebody that you love. For somebody that you love that might not be in the faith, you can offer these 9 first Fridays and then pick, when you're done with that soul, okay, now it's for my husband. Okay, now I'm gonna offer it for the guy who cut me off when I was driving the car. So you can offer it for people that they don't even know that you're praying for them, and you consecrate them to the Sacred Heart of Jesus. If you are lacking in your Eucharistic devotion, if you have only been going to Mass on Sunday, the third tip I have for you is to be more Eucharistic-centered. Go to Mass more frequently. Why? All of this devotion results in love for Jesus Christ in the Most Holy Eucharist. Why the Eucharist? Have you ever noticed that when there is a miracle of the Eucharist, the Eucharistic miracle, the first miracle is obviously the one that we do not see, transubstantiation, where the body, blood, soul, and divinity of Jesus Christ is present. There's no longer bread present. It's just Jesus himself. Well, sometimes in a Eucharistic miracle, it turns to flesh, and that flesh is the heart. Why? Again, because what is the symbol of the heart? The symbol of the heart is a complete self-giving. So yes, Jesus gave himself completely out of love for you. He died for you on the cross. But in the Eucharist, he's offering himself completely to you. He's offering you all that he has and all that he is. And all he wants is your love in return. And he told St. Margaret Mary that his heart was pierced, that he suffers so greatly now, in the Most Holy Eucharist, more than he suffered in his entire life because of the ingratitude of men, because we do not appreciate the Eucharist. Sometimes we even desecrate the Eucharist by the way he's handled, by the way he's received at Mass. Sometimes, God forbid, even priests desecrate the Eucharist on accident by not being careful with the particles. Absolute reverence is necessary to show Jesus just how much we appreciate him, just how much we love him. So the final and the most difficult tip that we have to bring about the reign of Jesus Christ, to bring about the Eucharistic reign of our Lord Jesus Christ is what? Is to love and to adore him and really make Jesus in the Eucharist the source and the summit of our life. Go to Mass more than just on Sunday. Strive to receive Holy Communion every day. And if you can't, at the very least, make it a point to do everything possible to receive Holy Communion on the first Friday. And do everything possible to discourage communion in the hand. Communion in the hand leads to desecration of the Most Holy Eucharist. Particles fall to the ground. And not only that, but it subverts the grace that you receive, because we receive grace according to the mode and the disposition of the receiver. So by treating Jesus in the Eucharist like ordinary bread, like I would receive bread in the hand from somebody, I wouldn't receive it directly in my mouth. Well, by receiving it ordinarily, that closes off my soul to receiving grace, because we are a union of body and soul united. The more my body acts like it, the more my soul acts like it. The two are united, they're inseparable. Greater reverence equals more grace. So discourage that and encourage Eucharistic devotion, encourage devotion to the Sacred Heart of Jesus. Why? Because St. Margaret Mary says that Jesus promised to her that anybody who promotes devotion to the Sacred Heart, that they themselves will have their names written on his heart and that will never be wiped away. Devotion to the Sacred Heart is very important. And truly, you really can't understand what it means to be a Christian. You can't understand who Christ was really unless you understand that His heart was one that was on fire out of love for His people. He's offering us His heart. He's offering us all that He is and all that He has, and that's all that He can be. And our response is to offer ourselves back to Him fully. In heaven, we're going to experience this union, God willing, and on earth, we are called now to give our hearts back to Him, especially in the Most Holy Eucharist, especially offering acts of reparation on the first Friday, reparation for your family and friends, also reparation for all the sacrileges and indifference that He suffers because of our own lukewarmness. And then finally, the easiest thing you can do, get an image of the Sacred Heart of Jesus. Put it in a prominent place on your home so that everybody who enters your home will know Jesus Christ is the King. God bless you, God love you, and we'll see you next week.